Are you familiar with mansplaining? You know what that is?
Yeah, that's when a man explains something to a woman in a patronizing way.
Actually, it's when a man explains something to a woman in a condescending way. But you were close.
Okay.
Biological sex is an ambiguous word that has no scale and no meaning.
Biological sex is fake.
There's no such thing as a biological woman.
Biological woman is completely meaningless because being a woman is a social state, not a biological one.
Biology is a lot more complicated than you were taught in high school.
I was born in the wrong body.
I am a biological female, and me saying that makes a lot of people very angry.
I am biological, and I am a woman. So therefore, I am a biological woman.
And we are psychologically and biologically women.
Because I am assigned female at birth. Yes, I did assign that myself, but I don't see how that's relevant.
The doctor who assigned my gender at birth was wrong.
The emphasis being here on the word assigned and that it was the doctor who made that decision.
Whence does thy biological ladyship derive?
The reality is there's no such thing as a male or a female.
There's women, and within women there's cis and trans.
Is it chromosome?
Born boy, brain, girl?
Hormones? Brain function?
Boy, girl!
Is't that thou bleedest?
There are people that have penises, there are people that had uteruses.
Genitalia?
Is the thing, love. Male genitalia doesn't exist. Unfortunately, science says that genitalia is more of a spectrum.
Science has proved that trans people have the brain that they identify with.
One study found that trans women who, despite being assigned male at birth, had a smaller female-sized structure in the hypothalamus.
You're just a woman with a small brain, with a brain a third the size of us. It's science.
And I go, okay, mom, you see me as boy, I sad, I kill myself.
And it's so much easier to change the body to match the brain than it is to change the brain to match the body.
The clit and the dick are literally just at different stages of development.
Every time somebody or a group of somebodies has tried to set out a very clear, definitive distinction between man and woman, they fail.
False concepts of what is biologically true for human beings has been used as a tool of oppression for our whole history.
The meaning of period, womanhood, femininity has been constructed by the patriarchy.
Gender is a social construct.
Now, when I say gender is socially constructed,
I'm telling you, it's all made up. Gender is a social construct.
Gender is a social construct.
Gender is a social construct.
Social construct.
What does it mean when people say gender is a social construct?
Being told since birth that you should have a gender identity that our society made up to match an organ that you couldn't pick.
The idea of there only being two genders is a new concept that is directly linked to white supremacy.
There are many, many more gender identities than we originally thought and can even begin to grasp.
Being cisgender is actually very problematic and toxic, racist, everything.
So we all know that cis heteronormativity and compulsive heterosexuality are big issues in our culture and society, including for straight people, but especially for gender nonconforming trans queer people, because it often marginalizes, oppresses, and literally destroys us.
Gender binary is a direct result of European colonization.
The gender binary is a racist cultural construction created by white scientists in the 19th century as a means of showing the supposed superiority of Western civilization at being the only culture able to uphold sexual dichotomy.
About the struggle of being a woman as a biological one. I don't have a uterus, and while I empathize with anyone who does and struggles with the menstrual cycle, when you say, being a woman's so hard because of my period, I don't have a period, so it's kind of like,
Day 31 of being a girl, and I'm freaking out a little bit.
I haven't gotten my period yet.
Important things to remember. Not everyone who has a period is a woman, and not every woman has a period. Period.
That had not occurred to us, dude.
I mean, I haven't kissed anyone in a while, but still, like, we know what happened to the Virgin Mary, okay? It's possible.
Women have periods, men have periods, and non-binary individuals have periods.
Did you know trans women can get their period just like cis women?
Pretty predictably, once a month, I have, like, PMS symptoms.
Why do you say you feel trapped in a man's body?
Well, sometimes I get the menstrual cramps real hard.
Okay, sweetie, so apparently you're not wanting to understand or listen.
Does everyone who have a uterus have a period? No.
Trans women experience a whole myriad of PMS, aka period, symptoms, takes absolutely nothing away from you or your womanhood.
Does everyone who have a period have a uterus? Also no.
I can tell you right now, my period I experience every month is very real, very valid, and very painful.
We do, in fact, get periods. We do.
Why? Stop.
But you know what? You go ahead and keep invalidating trans women. You go ahead and keep telling them that their experience is not real.
Not hot. I swear to God, if anyone says welcome to womanhood.
The audacity and just the arrogance for cis women to believe that they own periods.
Honestly, you're still comparing apples to oranges here. You don't know anything.
You don't.
Stop and think before you write stupid shit on my post.
And trans women who are on hormones can have PMS-like symptoms.
Essentially, the shedding of the uterine lining, aka the bleeding, is just one symptom of a period that some people can experience.
Because we both have the blueprint for both sexes and the brain sees very little testosterone and a bunch of estrogen and goes, oh, I know what to do with this.
What in God's holy name are you blathering about?
We do have the same symptoms. The bloating, the gas, irritability, the mood swings.
Hot flashes, mood swings, nausea, insomnia, fatigue, appetite changes.
And the gas has been really stinky.
I will get cramped so bad sometimes I don't want to crawl out of bed.
But once I started looking at my timeline, I realized, oh, about once a month I made a really sad crying video.
Now, I did mention that we don't have the parts to bleed, technically, but for someone like me, being a switch, I like backdoor play, and I've noticed that during this time, I do end up getting a little bit of blood coming out of there when it doesn't normally happen. So, take your own judgment on that one, I guess.
Now, I'm gonna put it in my purple panties. These are clean, by the way. I just got them out of the drawer, but these purple panties, okay? So, you see right here,
menstruation is seen as gross, disgusting, a joke, and as someone who does not menstruate, I'm non-binary, I don't menstruate, I wanted to help end that stigma if I could.
Peel it apart back, and there's the stickies. See that shiny area is sticky.
So I'm gonna tell you guys my first period story. So this was about 10 months ago when I first got my SRS, my surgery, my pussy surgery, and then when I got home, I went to go pee, because I had to pee really bad, and then I looked down and I was gushing out fucking blood, like pouring blood out of my, yeah.
That morning I woke up with blood in my underwear, and at first I was like, oh my gosh, this is so gender affirming, did I finally get a visit from the period fairy?
Day 12 of being a girl, and we're gonna go buy tampons.
Day 75 of being a girl, and I've been carrying around tampons and pads for the past 2 months.
This thing does not go up inside you. Like, where does that go? Oh my God, what the hell?
Just go like that,
It shouldn't matter to you where this goes.
That's a major national brand paid me to make this ad for them on social media.
So a little while ago, I got an email from a company asking me to advertise their heating pad for like period cramps.
I've even had a woman ask me for a tampon. And guess what? I had it.
I got some right here for you.
I have no problem saying that I have a tampon or two in my purse that I give to anyone who might need it.
Why is a trans woman buying up all the tampons?
No one can call me a tampon whore. People of all genders use tampons, not just
anybody
women.
Anybody need a tampon?
Any tampons?
Tampon.
I'm giving out tampons.
You need a tampon by chance?
Tampon.
Today I want to tell y'all how I could be the world's first pregnant transgender woman.
Now am I actually going to be the first one? Who knows?
But you're probably wondering, how can a transgender woman be pregnant if she doesn't have a uterus? Well, that's why you do a uterine transplant.
Let's talk about how post-op trans women can get pregnant. As with any childbearer, the hip bones must be wide enough set that passing a newborn through the vaginal canal is feasible. Sometimes the pelvic bone is broken during labor when there's not enough room. In the case of trans women, hormone replacement therapy during puberty alters the way bones grow to make vaginal birth possible and sports enthusiasts mad.
So, I'm 34 weeks today.
Thank you so much. There seems to be a lot of people that I've upset by coming forward about my pregnancy and being the first trans woman to naturally get pregnant and carry a baby.
Be patient with me. I'm somewhere between losing my mind and finding my soul.
By the way, not every woman breastfeeds or is able to. And in fact, trans women can breastfeed.
Did you know trans women can breastfeed?
I leak milk too, and mine tastes like a cis woman's.
How exciting! Mommy make milky!
Trans women can lactate.
I can breastfeed.
Yeah, I tasted it. It's good. They tested the milk for its purity, and they said, it's good. You could feed the baby. I said, yay!
Oh, I have to put it on here.
The baby has been able to latch, but I've not been able to produce any milk. It's okay.
I want to be a woman. From now on, I want you all to call me Loretta.
What?
It's my right as a man.
Well, why do you want to be Loretta, Stan?
I want to have babies.
You want to have babies?
It's every man's right to have babies if he wants them.
But you can't have babies!
Don't you oppress me.
I'm not oppressing you, Stan. You haven't got a womb. Where's the fetus gonna gestate? You're gonna keep it in a box?
The crisis for both physicians and psychologists in the 1950s was that they had no idea what made people male or female. It wasn't chromosomes, it wasn't gonads, right? It wasn't hormonal composition, it wasn't genetics. They couldn't find any one facet of biology that predicted reliably who would be male or female.
In a new dawn of gender and sex complexity.
To everyone celebrating Transgender Day of Visibility, I want you to know that your president sees you.
I strongly feel that diversity, in all of its myriad and wonderful aspects, should be welcomed and actually celebrated for the way that it strengthens and enhances any community.
There are a lot of schools that are moving towards gender-neutral bathrooms,
And if we add female, we might become obsolete very quickly.
And as a congresswoman, and I am committed to doing the absolute most to protect Black birthing people.
Saving people with a period.
With a woman, with a female or menstruating person's body.
Many women, cis women, have the capacity for pregnancy. Many cis women do not have the capacity for pregnancy. There are also trans men who are capable of pregnancy, as well as non-binary people who are capable of pregnancy.
It's science.